Hey guys, I want to tell you the secret of the day of Christ versus the day of the Lord in the Bible. So, if you've been studying or learning about the Bible for a while, maybe you've come across a lot of different teachings on this subject. But here's the thing: the day of the Christ and the day of the Lord are the exact same thing. Okay? The reason why one of them is called the day of Christ and one of them is called the day of the Lord. Well, the reason it's called the Day of Christ is to show that Christ is God, is to proclaim the deity of Christ, that he is equal with God the Father in deity, that he is God, he is Lord. So the Day of the Lord was always spoken of in the Old Testament. In the New Testament, we have the same day referenced to as the day of Christ to show the deity of Christ. It's very simple, actually, indeed. And there are many other situations like this in the Bible. You've got the kingdom of heaven, the kingdom of God, the same thing, two different titles to show different things. Of course, God is in heaven. Heaven is where God is. There's lots of other situations like the names and titles of the Holy Spirit. Why is the Holy Spirit called the Holy Spirit? It's called the Spirit of God, and yet it's also called the Spirit of Christ. Okay, these are not multiple separate spirits, more persons in the Godhead. No, it's the same Spirit, different titles to show different aspects. Okay, and once again, it would be called the Spirit of Christ. Again, to show the deity of Christ. Okay. So, dispensationalists like to split up all these things. When I was first studying, and I'm still figuring out a lot of things, but I thought that dispensationalism at its core was okay, and that it was just the hyper-dispensationalists that took things out of context, because, you know. Anyways. And there are varying degrees within dispensationalism, but still, I've decided just to throw the whole thing out because they're to blame for confusion like this when they like to split things up and give different meanings to things in the Bible that aren't even there. So, and I was listening to Brian Denlinger. I made a video the other day. I spoke of it on 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, and I was listening to Edward Finninger today, who's kind of rebutting what he said because there's this whole debate within futurists and dispensationalists. There's so many different interpretations of 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, but there's this whole debate of which I got sucked into it for a while. 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, let me just go there real quick again, just so I say it right. 2 Thessalonians chapter 2 mentions the day of Christ. Okay, the day of Christ is at hand. And so there's this huge debate: is it the day of Christ or is it the day of the Lord? Is it the day of Christ or is it the day of the Lord? They're the exact same thing, folks. And guess what? Neither one of them is the rapture, and neither one of them is this physical coming of Christ on the earth to rule and reign for 1,000 years, because all of that is made up nonsense. All of it. The fact that, the false idea that the day of Christ and the day of the Lord are separate, that's false. The rapture, that's false. The Christ ruling and reigning for 1,000 years on the earth, that's false. Okay? They're both the same thing. They're just different titles. There's one coming of the Lord. It's his coming for judgment. It's when you'll be judged as an individual. Okay? When we die, we meet the Lord. That's why it's at hand. That's why it comes as a thief in the night. It could happen at any time. Thank you. God bless.